know they will grow up in the way Wendy knew was this. One day when she was 2 years old, she was playing in a garden and she plucked another flower and ran with it to her mother. I suppose she looked rather delightful, for Mrs. Darley put her hand to her heart and cried.
Oh, why can't he remain like this forever? This was all that passed between them on the subject. But henceforth, Wendy knew she must grow up.
I won't go to bed. I won't, I won't. Oh, Nana, it isn't even 6 o'clock yet. Oh, dear, I shan't love you anymore. I tell you, I won't be late. I won't, I won't.
Where's Joy's there?
Oh, John, you sound just like Father.
I say, I'm happy to inform you, Mrs. Darling, that you're now a mother.
Oh, happy day. I shall call her Wendy.
I say, I'm even happier to inform you, Mrs. Darling, that you're now the mother of a male child as well.
Sweet little John. May I eat one also?
No! We do not want any more.
Nobody wants me.
I do. I so want a third child.
Boy or girl?
Boy. Oh, why, what is the matter, Father dear?
The matter is this tie. It will not tie. Not round my neck. Round the bedpost. Oh, yes, 20 times I have tied it round the bedpost. But round my neck, no, begs to be excused.
Oh, George.
I warn you of this, Mother. This tie is not tied tonight. We do not go out. And if I do not go out, I never return to the office again. And if I never return to the office, you and I will starve, and our children will be flung into the streets.
Oh, my George.
Oh, thank you, dear. Now, where's my Elizabeth boy?
What?
Oh! Oh! Oh, dash it all, Nana! Oh, you have covered my trousers with hairs.
I'm sure she didn't mean to, Father.
Not only were these blue trousers, but the first I ever had with braid on them.
Now, George, just hold still.
Sometimes I think it was a mistake to have a dog before a nurse.
Mother.
Oh, no, dear one. Nana's a treasure.
No doubt. But I worry sometimes she looks upon the children as puppies.
Oh, no, dear one, I feel sure she knows they have souls.
I wonder, I wonder.
But, George, I have a meaning to tell you something peculiar. I believe that while the children sleep, they have been receiving an uninvited visitor.
A visitor? No one can get to the house without first knocking.
Well, I do believe he comes in by the window.
By the window? It's 3 stories up.
Well, yes, but you see, Nana had just returned from eating out, and she sprang into Strange Boy, who simply leapt through the window. Nana closed the window, too late to catch the boy, but smack came the shadow and it fell right off.
Well, let us have a look then.
You can be sure I examined it quite thoroughly.
Well, certainly nobody I recognize. But it does look a scoundrel.
But I don't want any medicine, Nana.
Be a man, Michael.
Well, well.
Oh, dear, let me fetch your chocolate.
Mother, don't pamper him. Michael, when I was a boy your age, I took my medicine without a murmur. I said, thank you, dear parents, for giving me bottles to make me well.
Medicine you sometimes take, Father, is much nastier, isn't it?
Ever so much nastier. And I will take it now as an example for you, but I've misplaced the bottle.
I know where it is, Father. I'll go get it.
It's that nasty, sticky, sweet kind, John.
It will soon be over, Father.
I have made as quick as I could.
You have been wonderfully quick. Well, Michael first.
Father first.
I shall be sick, you know.
Come on, Father.
Hold your tongue, John.
I thought you took it quite easily, Father.
Well, I do, but that is not the point. The point is there is more in my glass than in Michael's spoon. And that is not fair. I say it though it were my last words. It isn't fair.
Father, I am waiting.
So am I waiting, Michael.
Father's a cowardly custard.
You're a cowardly custard.
I'm not frightened.
Nor am I frightened.
Well, then take it.
Well, then you take it.
Why not both of you take it at the same time?
Splendid idea. Are you ready, Michael?
On the count of 3. 1, 2, 3! Not fair!
Bad form!
mean by oh, father, and stop that row, Michael. I meant to take it, I just missed. Oh, I just thought of a splendid joke. I will pour my medicine into Nana's milk bowl. She will drink it, thinking it is milk. Oh, what fun. Oh, Nana. Come here, Nana. I put some milk in your bowl.
Oh, she's a medicine.
Oh, it was only a joke. Oh, much would be slaving to the bone trying to be funny in this household. Oh, that's right, coddler. Nobody ever coddles me. Why should they? I am only the breadwinner. Oh, why? Why?
George, please, not so loud or the servants will hear you.
Oh, let them hear me. Bring in the whole world to hear me. Well, I will not allow that dog to load into my nursery for a moment longer.
Father, no!
In vain. Dogs belong in the yard, and that is where I'm going to tie you up this instant.
George, please, remember what I told you about that boy.
I have made up my mind. There can only be one master in this house.
Have you been too cold at night, Charles? And you, Michael?
No, Mother.
Man is unhappy. Listen to her bark.
It's because he's chewing her up in the yard.
That is not Nana's unhappy bark. That is her bark when she smells danger.
Are you sure, Wendy?
Oh, yes.
Oh, how I wish I wasn't going to the party tonight.
Oh, Mother, can anything harm us after the night lights are lit?
Nothing, precious. They have the eyes Mother leaves behind to guard the children.
Oh, Mother, I'm glad of you.
Good night, John.
Good night, Michael.
Tinkerbell, Tink, where are you?
Yeah.
Oh, do come out of that jug. And tell me, do you know where they put my shadow? In the big box?
Thank you.
Here. Now shall I give you a kiss?
If you wish to. I shall wear your kiss around my neck. How old are you?
I don't know, Windy, but I am quite young. Windy, I ran away the day I was born. It was because I heard father and mother talking about what I was to be when I became a man. I don't want ever to be a man. I want always to be a little boy to have fun. So I ran far away to Kinsley Gardens and lived a long time among the fairies.
Fairies? Tell me everything you know about fairies.
Well, Wendy, when the first baby laughed for the first time, its laugh broke into 1,000 pieces and they all went skimming about. And that was the beginning of fairies.
And so there ought to be one for every boy and girl.
Ought to be? Isn't there?
No. You know, children know such a lot now, and soon they don't believe in fairies. And every time a child says, I don't believe in fairies, there's a fairy somewhere that falls down dead. I can't think to where Tink has gotten to.
Tink?
Peter, you don't mean to tell me there is a fairy in this room? She was here with me when I came in a moment ago. You don't hear her, do you?
The only sound I hear is like the tinkle of bells.
Well, that's Tink and that's the fairy language. Windy, I do believe I shut you up in that drawer. You shouldn't say such things, Tink. Of course, I'm terribly sorry, but how was I to know that you were shut up in the drawer?
Oh, Peter, if only she'd stand still and let me see her.
Tink, this lady says that she wishes that you were her, Barry.
What does she say, Peter?
She's not very polite. She says that you're a great ugly girl, that she is my fairy.
You know you can't be my fairy, Tinkerbell, because I'm a gentleman and you're a lady.
She's quite a common fairy. They call her Tinkerbell because she moves the pots and kettles.
So, if you don't live in Kensington Gardens now,
sometimes I still do.
But where do you live mostly now?
With the Lost Boys.
Who are they?
They're the children who fall out of their parameters when the nurses are looking the other way. They're not leaving 7 days, they're sent far away to the Neverland to defray expenses.
I'm captain.
What fun it must be!
Yes, but we are rather lonely. You see, we have no female companionship.
None of the others are girls?
Oh, no. Girls, you see, are much too clever to fall out of their prams.
I think it's awfully sweet the way you talk about girls, Peter.
John there just despises us.
How formal for a first meeting, Peter. You're not the captain in my house. But I see you meant to be kind, so you may give me a kiss.
I thought you'd want it back.
No, no, I don't mean a kiss. I mean a thimble.
What's that?
It's like this.
Honey, now shall I give you a thimble?
If you wish to. Ow!
What is it?
It was exactly as if someone were pulling my hair.
It must have been Tink. I've never known her to be so naughty before. She says that she'll do that to you every time I try to give you a thimble.
But why? Why, Tink?
Well, did you come to the nursery window to see me, Peter?
Oh, no.
Just to listen to the stories.
I see.
Oh, Wendy, your mother was telling such a lovely story.
Really? Which story was it?
It was about the prince who couldn't find the lady with the glass slippers.
Peter, that was Cinderella. And he found her, and they lived happily ever after.
Where are you going? To tell the other boys.
Oh, there we go, Peter. I know such lots of stories. Oh, the stories I can tell to the boys. Let me go.
Do come with me to tell the other boys.
But I can't. Think of Mummy. Besides, I can't fly.
I'll teach you.
Oh, to fly!
I'll teach you how to jump on the wind's back and then away we'll go.
Ooh!
Wendy, when you were sleeping in your silly bed, you might have been flying about with me, saying funny things to the stars.
Oh,
There are mermaids.
Mermaids? With tails?
Such long tails.
Who to see a mermaid?
Wimpy, how we should all respect you.
Ooh.
You could tuck us in at night.
Ooh.
None of us have ever been tucked in at night.
Ooh.
And you could darn our clothes and make pockets for us.
Of course, it's frightfully fascinating. Peter, would you teach John and Michael to fly too?
If you like.
Wake up! Peter Valentine is to teach us to fly!
Can I shut it up? Well, I am not. Oh, it's quick!
There, you suspicious brute. They are perfectly sound asleep and fed. Listen to their gentle breathing.
Shh! Oh, shh!
No more than that! I shall be calm again. I shall call for master and missus. And oh, will the master is with you.
It's all right. I say, Peter, can you really fly?
Wow.
How tiny!
Whenever you see me forgetting you, just keep on saying
I would wake him first and then kill him.
That's the way I always do.
Do you kill many?
Tons.
How ripping!
Well,
let's have tea first.
Are there many pirates in the island just now?
I've never known so many.
Who's captain now? James Hook! Why? He was Blackbeard and Pirate's most son! He was the only man who walked on still and was afraid!
That's him.
I say, what is he like? Is he big?
He's not so big as he was.
I cut off a bit of him.
You?
Yes, me.
Well, I didn't mean to be disrespectful.
Oh, all right.
But I say, which bit was it?
His right hand.
Oh. So he can't fight now?
Oh, can't he just?
Left-hander?
He has an iron hook instead of a right hand. And he claws with it.
Claws?
I say, John.
Yes!
There is one thing that every boy who serves under me must promise, and so must you. It is this. If we ever come across Hook in open battle, you must leave him to me.
I promise.
Say aye, aye, sir.
Aye, aye, sir.
Tinkerbell tells me that the pirates spotted us before the darkness came, and they got the long tongue out.
The big gun?
Yes. And if they cross, they must see her light. And if they guess we are near, they are sure to let fly.
Wendy!
John! Michael! Peter, tell her to go away at once!
She's afraid that we've lost the way and she's rather frightened. You don't go to her way all by herself when she's frightened, do you?
Then tell her to put out her light!
She can't put it out. It just goes out of itself when she sleeps. Same as the stars.
Then tell her to go to sleep at once!
She can't sleep except when she's sleeping. It is the only other thing Marius can't do.
It seems to me like these are the only two things actually worth doing. Ow! How far away is Neverland?
Very far.
Are you serious?
Yes.
How long can we get there when you're tired?
Wait! What's that sound?
That's the sound of the wild beast drinking from the river. What's that sound?
That's the sound of the Indians sharpening their knives.
If only something would make a sound.
Strange dress. crocodiles.
Not of crocodiles, but that one crocodile. Like my arm so much to me, I follow the exits from land to land and sea to sea.
In a way, it's not a compliment.
I want no such compliments.
I want Peter Pan, who first gave the prudence taste for me. It's me. The crocodile had me before this, but I like a chance at swallowing clock that goes tick, tick inside of it. And so before I reaches me, I hear the tick and bolt.
And one day, the clock will run out, and then they'll get you.
That's the fear that haunts me. It's me.
A chimney?
Did you hear them say that Peter Pan's away from home?
Under your gun, Captain. To return to the ship and cook a large-rich cake of a jolly thickness with green sugar on it. We'll leave the cake on the shore of the Mermaid's Lagoon. These boys are always talking about their plan with the mermaids. They will find the cake and they will gobble it up because, having no mother, they don't know how dangerous it is to eat rich dark cake. They will die.
It's the wickedest, prettiest party I've ever heard of, Captain.
A lost belay when I appear, my fear that overtook. Not slept upon your boat, but you have shaken claws with the hook. The crocodile!
Hello,
Peter.
Hello.
I will call in the evening. Make sure to get a cup of tea and a cup with a spout to it.
Where am I?
Where, dear lady? For you we have long waited, and we are your children.
Oh, what dear lady, be your mother!
Not I. Of course, it's frightening, fascinating. But you see, I'm only a little girl. I have no real experience.
That doesn't matter. All we need is just a nice motherly person.
Oh, dear. You see, I feel that is exactly what I am.
It is.
We saw it at once.
Very well, I will do my best. Now get inside and lunch, you naughty children. I'm sure your feet are damp. And before I put you to bed, I have just enough time to finish the story of Cinderella.
Hooray!
Now, Peter told me you left off where Cinderella was battling the pirates.
Shut your eyes. Everyone, shut your eyes. Shut them. I want to see everybody's eyes shut. Shut them. Shut your eyes. Shut your eyes. And if you are a lucky one, you will see a shapeless pool of lovely pale colors suspended in the darkness. If you squeeze them a little tighter, the pool will begin to take shape, and the colors will become so vivid that with another squeeze, they must go on fire.
But just before they go on fire, you see a lagoon. This is the nearest you get to it on the mainland. Just one heavenly moment, and if there could be 2 moments, you might see the slope and hear the mermaids singing.
Open your eyes!
Dear mother, may I please have another swim? Oh, slightly, darling, you know it's my duty as your mother to ensure that you rest for half an hour after the day.
Oh, mother, you never let us swim when we want to.
Michael, surely you know I'm not your real mother.
Then who is?
I dare say I once knew your real mother, Michael.
Oh, dear. John, Michael, I do think it's time for another examination.
This is awfully interesting.
Are you ready? Very well. Question one. What were the colour of mother's eyes? Question two. Which was taller, father or mother? And question three. Was mother blonde or brunette? Answer all three questions if possible.
What do I do if I can't answer one of the questions?
It must just make cross. Now time for the essay question. Write an essay of no less than 40 words on how I spent my last holidays or the characters of mother and father compared. Only one of these to be attempted.
Miss Wendy!
Yes, Lively.
May I share my essay with the class? I'm sure it'll make the highest marks.
I suppose, yes.
How I spent my last holidays. On my last holidays, mother and father took me to a great white beach with lots and lots and lots of white sand and lots and lots and lots of seashells. And the beach was also full of flamingos. Lots and lots and lots and lots of pink flamingos. And we rode the flamingos up and down the beach, but sometimes we took turns and the flamingos rode us.
Are you slightly?
I thought that was what one did on holiday.
Pirates! Down!
Is all well?
Aye.
Game's off. Those boys have found the mother.
Oh, evil day.
Behold, it's poison cake. I've left it in one cunning spot after another, yet always the mother snatches it from the hands of her children, and so let it time it has become as hard as stone. What's a mother?
He doesn't know!
What was that?
I heard nothing.
See, that is a mother. Yeah. What a lesson! The nest was to fall in its water. But would a mother desert her eggs? No.
Perhaps if they have a mother, she's hanging around to help Peter.
Aye, that's the fear that haunts me.
Captain! Captain! Can we not take their mother? Hey, make her our mother? It's just a princely scheme. We'll seize the children and carry them to the ship. The boys will make one complaint, and Mickey shall be our mother.
Never!
What was that?
I think it was a leak in the wind.
Do you agree, my police?
There's my end of it.
And boys.
Swear.
We swear.
Where's the Indian?
That's okay, Captain. We let her go.
Let her go.
Just like your orders, shout us over the water.
That's I gave her her daughter. Spirit that haunts this dark lagoon tonight does tear me.
Boards, borgs, hammers, and tongs. I hear you.
Who are you, stranger? Speak.
I'm James Hook, captain of the Jolly Roger.
You are not. You're not.
Brimstone and gall, sit down again, and I'll cast anchor in you.
If you are Hook, come tell me. Who am I?
A codfish. Only a codfish.
A codfish.
Have we been captained all this time by a codfish?
It's warming up, right?
Hook, have you another voice?
I have.
And another name?
I have.
Vegetable?
No.
Mineral?
No.
Animal?
Yes.
Man?
No.
Boy?
Yes.
Ordinary boy?
No.
Wonderful boy?
Yes.
Are you in England?
No.
Are you here?
Yes.
You ask this question.
I am the captain. Can't
guess, can't guess. Do you give it up?
Yes.
Yes.
Well then, I'm Peter Pan.
Pan!
No pun, it's me into the water. Get dead or alive.
No way. Are you ready, boys?
Aye, aye!
The Lord of the Pirates!
Pale rays of light tip
waters by and by, and there was to be heard a sound at once the most musical and the most melancholy. The mermaids called him to the moon.
Peter was not quite like other boys, but he was afraid at last, and a tremor ran through him like a shadow passing over the sea. But on the sea, one shadow follows another to the hundreds of them.
But Peter felt just one.
Next moment, he was standing erect on the rock with a smile on his face and a drum beating within him, and it was saying,
"To die will be an awfully big adventure."
Peter! Hello, Neverbird. I want you to get into the nest.
Sorry, I don't speak bird.
I want you to get into the nest, and then you can drift ashore, but I am too tired to bring it any further, so you must swim to me.
don't wish it. I don't. Peter, what are your exact feelings for me? Those of a devoted son, Wendy. Not so. You're so queer and Tiger Lily's just the same. There's something she wants to be to me, but she says it's not my mother.
No, indeed, it is not.
What is it? It isn't for a lady to tell.
Then very well.
Perhaps Tinkerbell will tell me.
Oh, she'll tell you, all right. Mm-hmm. She is an abandoned little creature.
She says she's always been abandoned. Perhaps Tinkerbell wants to be my mother.
I almost agree with her.
Listen, Beth, there was
wants me.
But Captain.
The Tom Tom and Indian victory!
Which of you is it to be?
I don't think my mother would like for me to be a pirate.
think so.
Would your mother like you to be a pirate twin?
I don't think so. Nibs, would your mother like
Stop
to-
that!
You boy. You know this, you had a little cup in you. This never wants to become a pirate to you, Barty.
I once thought of calling myself Red-Handed Jack.
And a good name too. We'll call you that here, bully, if you join.
What do you think, Michael?
What would you call me if I join?
Blackbeard Joe.
Would we still be respectful subjects of the king?
You have to swear. Down with the king.
The noise!
And I too!
Robertinia!
Steal your Jew. Bring up the mother. Hit the plank, buddy. So, my beauty, you to watch your children walk the plank.
Are they to die?
They are. Silence all for mother's last words to her children.
These are my last words, dear boys. I feel that I'm meant to choose your real mothers, and it is this. We hope our sons will die like English gentlemen.
I do enjoy mother's words. Do you enjoy mother's words, Sally?
I do.
Do you enjoy your mother's love, twin?
I do.
John, do you enjoy your mother's love?
Tie her up!
Listen here, Beauty. I promise to let you go. If you promise to be my mother.
Open the cabin door and drive them in. Make them fight the doodle-doo for their lives. If it kills them, we're not the better. If they kill them, him, we're not the worse.
Don't be silly. What do I matter? Do go back and keep an eye on the children.
Look.
Look at Mrs. Darling in her chair where she has fallen asleep. Some like Peter best and some like Wendy best, but I like her best. Suppose, to make her happy, we whisper to her in her sleep that the children are coming back. They're really within 2 miles and flying strong. And we need to whisper that they're on their way. Let's.
They're on their way!
Oh, Nana, I dreamt my dear ones had come back to me. George, you are as full of remorse as ever, aren't you?
Oh, full of remorse as ever, love. See my punishment? Sleeping on a dog bed?
But it is punishment, isn't it? You are sure you are not enjoying it?
My love.
Do beg your pardon, my love.
Would you play me to sleep on the nursery room piano? And would you please close that window? I feel the draught.
George, never ask me to do that again. The window must always be left open for them, always.
Design must play your part in my love.
Very soon. I don't want to go to school and learn solemn things.
I don't want to be a man. Oh, Wendy's mother, if I was to wake up and feel there was a beard.
Peter, I should love you in a beard.
Keep back from me, lady. No one's going to catch me and make me a man. I shall have such fun. May I, Mummy?
Of course not. I just got you back and I intend to keep you.
But he does so need a mother.
So do you, my love.
Oh, all right.
Peter, I make to you this offer to let Wendy go to you once a year for a week to do your spring cleaning.
I accept it.
Peter, you don't think you'll forget about me by the time spring cleaning comes, will you?
Of course not, Wendy.
Goodbye, Peter.
Bye.
Peter did come for spring cleaning, but the strange thing is that he never knew he missed a year. Wendy flew away with Peter in the frock she had woven from leaves and berries in the Neverland. But her one fear is that he might notice how short it had become. But Peter never did. He always had so much to say about himself. Wendy looked forward to the thrilling talks about the good old days, but the new adventures crowded the old ones from his mind.
Who's Captain Hook? You don't remember how you killed him and saved all our lives?
I forget them after I kill them.
Wendy eventually began to wait in a new frock, for the old one simply would not fit. But he was slow coming and forgetful so very often. Wendy often worried. Peter never seemed like he was going to come back. Until one night.
Hello, Wendy.
Hello, Peter.
Is John here?
No, he's not.
Is Michael sleeping?
That is not Michael.
Hello, is it a new one?
Yes. Boy or girl?
Girl.
Yes.
Yeah.
Peter, do you expect me to fly away with you?
Of course, Wendy, that's why I've come.
Have you forgotten it's spring cleaning time?
I can't go with you, Peter. I've forgotten how to fly.
I'll soon teach you again.
Oh, don't wish to fairy dust on me.
What is it?
I shall turn up the light and you shall see for yourself.
Don't turn up the light!
I grew up, Peter. I am ever so much more than 20. I grew up a long time ago.
But you promised not to.
I couldn't help it. I'm a married woman, Peter.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am. And in that bed is my baby, Jane.
No, she's not.
Thank you.